Shalom, Israel, Most High, Christ bless. We got another episode of Casting Down Imaginations. I'm your host, Officer Abiyah. To my left,
I'm Officer Yosha.
And to his left,
Soldier Lemuel.
Soldier Lemuel. Yeah. We got another one for y'all. We have been gone a couple days due to the Feast of Tabernacle. It was a big, beautiful event.
That's right.
Yes. Out there in the wilderness, I got to see a lot of you brothers and sisters that tune in. All praises to the Most High. It was a blessing seeing y'all. It was a blessing just spending time with everybody out there in the wilderness, y'all. High holy days is the best, man. The Most High gave us real high holy days.
The brothers obey.
The brotherhood and unity out there in the wilderness, man, was beautiful. If it wasn't for the Most High's Feast of Tabernacle, I don't think us black folks would ever go out there in the wilderness like that.
Right.
But I'm glad he did, man.
Yep.
You know?
It was beautiful.
I miss being here.
Yeah?
I miss you, fam.
Right.
I miss y'all, man. I miss being here. You been here all the while. What's been going on, man? I been having a good time?
Yes, sir.
Without us? Oh, man.
Man, you know this truth. I always going to have to go forward.
I hear that.
Praises to the Most High.
Oh, I hear that.
We got mic stands now.
I'm still old school. Right. I got a mic stand right here. But y'all know me. I'm old school. Hey, the scoffers back.
Well, the scoffers.
They ain't going to take
over. They ain't going to go. Oh man, they ain't going nowhere.
All praises for the scholars. We doing something right.
But today's topic, y'all, is something in all seriousness. We all got a job to do. You brothers, sisters, men, children, and women. We all got a job to do. Every last one of us got a job to do in this truth to ensure that our people wake up. Our people, if they come in and they need something, we be there to provide. Even the ones that's already in the truth, we need to work. Know how to dwell in unity, no schisms,
right.
No strifing. We got a job to do because we want to be acceptable and perfect when Christ, the black Messiah, show back up.
That's right.
And that's the mission. That is the mission, to wake up the 12 tribes and keep these commandments in the faith in the Son.
This is our job. This is what we must do. All right?
Exactly.
For these last days, brothers I knew, brothers, they get weary. You know, they get tired because guess what? You got your family, you got bills, you know, you got all kind of afflictions that happen one after another, you know, you lose your job, bills pile up,
right? On top of that, you see brothers and sisters getting shot dead in the street on a daily basis.
And you want to help your people.
Right. Some of us want to act out, you know, but the scriptures say no. It ain't time for that. It's only time to read that Bible.
Right.
You know? It's mine.
Right.
So it's a reason why this is going on. First of all, it's our fault.
Right.
We can yell, Esau the devil. Yeah, he's the devil. You know, you right. And we can point the finger at him all day long. But guess what? It's our fault.
Right.
We the ones who broke the commandments. So we the ones who got to fix it. We the ones who have to keep the commandments.
It all falls back on us.
So what we gonna do, we gonna take, you know, a quick commercial break. It's okay to call it commercial. Music break.
That's right.
You know, we gotta listen to some music.
Can't get mad at the belt.
You know? And do what we do best. DJ Amakai. On them ones and twos, you should, boy.
Turn up your mic.
Oh yeah, for those that was in the activities or the Feast of Tabernacles, I knew y'all was scared. Y'all don't want to finish those domino tournament, but it's all right though. We knew Oklahoma was gonna take it away. We good? Okay. He trying to get one of those hitters queued up right now.
That's what I'm talking about.
Try to get one of them hitters queued up.
You rocking in that cubicle this morning, in your car, wherever you at.
Boy, we got them hits.
Better get ready. Get your eardrums ready.
No, but yeah, we got a job to do, all seriousness, y'all. We gonna go over some scriptures with that. You know, we gonna have to, you know, put it in full perspective. Because if everybody ain't on the same page, we gonna be fractured. You know, something that is fractured can't stand, man.
Yeah, we're gonna go into it today. You know what I'm saying? We're gonna go over a little bit today.
We can't get the kingdom unless we come together.
Yeah. We good? All right. DJ M. McKeezy. Boy, he just got his tools set up, man. We, you know, we was in the wilderness. All of this, we was in the wilderness bumping. What, 17, you know, the time it took to run it? 3,000 people watched it on Periscope.
Live watching
Reed. Live watching Reed.
It was live, too. It was all the way live.
Hey, those children did a good job, man. They stayed disciplined.
Excellent.
Hey, turn his great mic job. Up. Turn his mic up.
You know, and you know, of course, the brothers came through. Soldier Kalia is a good actor.
Soldier,
I would say
Kalia killed that thing.
Yeah, he was a great actor.
Soldier Kalia did too.
Man. Yeah, he did.
So Soldier who?
Kalia.
Yeah, he was a lion in Judah. It
Who was in there?
Soldier Kalia.
He was a lion in Judah.
He was the lion in Judah. Yeah.
Okay.
And we had
some brothers didn't get to, even though I was there. I couldn't get
the. And Lahab was King Saul, man.
Yeah, he did.
Brother Lahab was King Saul, man. He did a good job, man.
Man, everybody did a good job, man. All together.
For those brothers who was there and didn't get to see everything, and he was working security, look, that's the work, man. Don't.
We ain't no commercial break.
Oh, you're not?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, all right, turn me up then. Shoot. That's it? Yeah, that sounds better right now. I like that. Yeah, for those brothers who was like, you know, it was cleanup duty, security, what else?
Hands on deck to put things up, to break things right. down.
Yeah, I commend you brothers, you know. The brothers, as far as I know, stayed in the spirit, you know.
Right.
That's a good thing, man, because without you, we couldn't get it done. Couldn't get it done, you know? So, I praise you, brothers.
You know what? We ain't worried about music right now. We ain't gonna, let's all get right. into it. Let's get
let's
into it.
All right, let's yeah. just get
let's do this.
Romans 15
and 4.
And 4. Because this will. We get our answers from y'all, the Bible. We don't go to the Glock, you know, we don't go to the AK-47.
Right.
This is what bothers me. People talk about grabbing arms against the so-called, People talk about grabbing arms against the so-called white man, right?
Mm-hmm.
All these groups, all these missionary groups, so-called,
Militant groups.
And I'm talking to our people. I ain't talking about nobody else. I'm talking about our people, mainly, who said we need to get guns. Listen, man. I laugh at every time I hit it, I laugh because the bishop made a joke about it every time. When you run out of bullets, where you gonna get your bullets from?
Right.
Where you gonna get that news, my man? Hold on. Time out. Time out. I need more bullets. Can I have your bullets? I mean, can I buy some more bullets so I can finish shooting at you?
Right. What sense that make?
Come on, man. We have to wake up. We have to believe in the God of this Bible.
That's
he
right.
will deliver us.
Right.
We have to. He will deliver us. He did it. He did it in Egypt, and he gonna do it again. He gonna do it again. All right, we're going to read that after we read this. Go ahead.
Romans chapter 15, verse 4.
Come on.
For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning. That
this Bible was written for our learning, for Israel. This Bible was written for our learning. This book of mysteries and secrets belong to us.
Right.
Nobody else. That's why...
Bring it
that's, that's why the so-called white man get mad. Well, that don't mean it. Look, it doesn't matter what you say. Because it ain't for you. You ain't going to never understand this book. You have to come to us to learn this. The table is being turned. The table is being turned. We are keeping God's commandments. We are waking up. That's the prophecy. Read that again.
Romans chapter 15, verse 4.
Come on.
For whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning.
Come on.
That we, through patience and comfort of the scriptures, might have hope.
That's what I'm trying to tell y'all. We're going to get our hope and strength from these from this Bible. And you read on top of that, it says, the things written aforetime were written for our learning, right? Get Deuteronomy chapter 29. It started, and I made a statement, right? 29:29. I made a statement about how this is our book and it belongs to us.
Right.
So watch this. You know what an inheritance is? Do y'all know what an inheritance is? Is when your parents, your father leave you with something after he passed, you know, when he died, you get his land or you get everything he owned.
Right.
Right?
He put you in his will.
He put you in his will, right? So that's the same thing the Most High did. Most High ain't dead, but guess what?
That's what Christ did.
He ain't dead.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, but I want to show you what he done for us, because that is our Father. And what he left for us. So read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 29. The secret things belong to the Lord our God.
You ain't going to look. The secret things belong to God. Man want to know everything. They want to search out the deep. They didn't even say, you know, all the technology man got, they haven't done it yet. When I say man, it's so-called white man. He haven't done it yet. He haven't explored all of space. You know, he don't even understand where all Israel at. You understand?
Right.
He don't understand this Bible. He don't know what's going on. His pride got him thinking that.
Can't understand it.
But read that. What the Bible said? The Bible said the secret things belong to the Lord.
Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 29. The secret things belong to the Lord our God.
Our God. Our God. Read.
But those things which are revealed belong unto us to our children forever.
He said the things that are revealed. The things that are revealed belong to us and our children forever.
That we may do all the works.
Hold on, man. You can't just hold on. Oh, listen. Hold on. I know we got to get back into the mashing thing. See, I've been gone for a while. He got to learn how I do. You know what I'm saying? That's a heavy hitter right there.
Right.
That's heavy.
That's heavy.
I'm surprised. I'll be honest, crying right now.
I gotta holler.
You gotta read that again, bro. You gotta read that part again, because I think we forget this. This was the Most High left for us. Did this change?
Nope.
No, this haven't changed. He said forever. So how can other nations grab into that? This possessive. This is a cut to everything. The Most High is not a liar.
Right.
So he forgot he wrote that right there? Ooh, I forgot I wrote that, so I gotta go. Read that.
The whole thing?
Yeah.
Deuteronomy.
I like that.
Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 29. The secret things belong unto the Lord our God. But those things which are revealed belong unto us and to our children forever.
The things that is revealed to us, like right now, that we gonna get the king, all this stuff that I watch debates with these so-called, I'm not gonna even mention his name, these so-called scholars talking about, you know, we just making stuff up, you just don't understand what's going on.
Lost in the sauce.
You just don't understand what's going on. The Bible is our book.
Right.
Period. It's our book. And the Most High is revealing his word to us. The ones who keep it in his law, statutes, commandments. There's nothing you can do about it. Because it's written.
Right. Let me get a couple scriptures real quick.
Wait, hold on, I'm going to finish it off.
Go ahead.
That we may do all the words of this law.
So we got to do all the words of the law. Go ahead.
All right, give me Nehemiah 8 and 8 first, and then we're going to go back into Nehemiah 2 and 19.
Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 8.
Hey, Amakai, turn me up a little bit. I can barely hear. Just a little bit. Yeah, okay, we in. All right, read that.
Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 8.
You men that go out and teach, this is your number one job. Come on.
So they read in the book, in the law of God distinctly. And gave the sense and caused them to understand the reading.
We must cause Jake, our people, the ones that don't know that they Israel, we must give them the understanding of the word. So what? We ain't gonna go into no deep mysteries on the street no. because they can't even understand that Christ is black.
Right.
No. You know what I'm saying? We going over Deuteronomy chapter 28 and we breaking that down. We going over the color of Jesus Christ. We breaking that down. If somebody got another question other than that, that's when we get into it.
And we go into the laws.
And we go into the commandments.
And
right.
And I want to add to what you said about Deuteronomy chapter 28. Brothers, I'm talking about you brothers who go out and teach. Don't ever, ever in your life think Deuteronomy 28 is beneath you. Because some brothers feel like, damn, we hear this all day, every day, you know what I'm saying? It's redundant and redundant to you. To you, because you, you know, we go out and preach all the time. We go out and teach all the time. You know, but guess what? That's what woke me up.
Right.
Now people ain't gonna understand Ezekiel chapter 34. You know what I'm saying?
Brothers be wanting to break out classes and I didn't look.
So people want to break down Revelations chapter 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Like, that's not going to wake our people
and
up.
And look, and they do that for us. They ain't trying to show out in front of us. Because the brothers on the street, the sisters on the street, they don't know what you're talking about.
Have no idea.
That's that vain glory. Stop it.
Please be mindful, because the job of you getting up with a microphone or without a microphone, teaching is what? Teaching they people the nationality that they must come back to the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God. That's your job.
Right.
That's the job. That is the job.
You know, Noah had one sermon, repent.
Christ, repent.
Repent. John the Baptist, repent. All the prophets had that same sermon. Repent. Repent. That's it. Now, in this day and age, the Most High gave us Deuteronomy chapter 28 because we was going to forget who we were. Right. And he said, use that book for a sign. Because those curses are a sign to show who the real Israel are today. So that's why we use it. They got to remember who they are. Our people got to remember that they are the children of God.
Right.
That's what the scriptures say. It say there in that, what is scripture at? When it says that's the place, Hosea?
Hosea 1 and 10.
All right, after that we're going to get that after you read church.
Right. So give me Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 19. Because when we out here teaching these scriptures, building the nation back from the dunghill, this is what's going to happen. This is recorded in the Bible. Nations have always done this when we've tried to rebuild. Nehemiah 2 and 19. Read that.
Nehemiah chapter 2, verse 19. But when
Sanballat,
the Horonite, and Tobiah, the servant, the Ammonite, and Geshem, the Arabian, heard it. They laughed us to scorn.
They laughed us to scorn because they heard that we was trying to build back our city, our temple that was destroyed. Come on.
They laughed us to scorn and despised us and said, what is this thing ye do? Will ye rebel against the king?
So they saw him out. We gonna go against basically the powers that be, not knowing that he let us go to build this. Come on. Read this.
Verse 20. Then answered I and said unto them, the God of heaven
Will he prosper us?
Our God will prosper us. This is for every scoffer on Periscope, every scoffer in the street, everybody that laugh us to scorn, calling us purple Power Rangers. Read that again.
Then answered I and said unto them, the God of heaven, he will prosper us.
The Most High God will prosper us.
Right.
You can laugh at us all day. But guess what? At the end of the day, God's word is going out.
Right.
Come on.
Therefore, we his servants will arise and build.
His servants will arise and build. You can call us every name in the book. You can call us the devil. You can call us a cult. But guess what? We're going to rise and we're going to build.
Right.
Come on.
But ye have no portion.
But you other nations have no portion. Come on.
Nor right
to this Bible. Read.
Nor memorial.
You ain't even thought about. Come on.
In Jerusalem,
the holy city. The place where the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans originate from. They have no portion.
I want to say something on that. Jerusalem is a people before it's a place. So right. You don't have no portion with us.
At all.
Remember that.
You can say, oh, God loves everybody. You're trying to be separatist. You're a hate group. When the Bible told you that you have no portion with us. You're nothing to God.
Wait, I want to finish on that?
Yes.
I want to back that up. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. To back him up.
Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 6. For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
God said this. He said, you are holy people, meaning a separate people. Read.
The Lord thy God has chosen thee to be a special people unto himself.
A special people unto himself. Come on.
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
I don't hear no equality in that.
Not at all.
He said, above all people, meaning all nations, all other nations on this earth.
Every last one of them is beneath the blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans.
Why you think they hate you so much? Why you think they want to kill you so fast?
Why do you think that they would shoot a man with his hands up when a car broke down in Tulsa, Oklahoma? Why? Just cause they finger slipped? Nah, it's pure hatred. They hate you.
I seen Edomite, so-called white man, it's Edomite. He was being tased and real disgruntled and stuff, yelling and screaming. They tased him about 3 or 4 times. And he just ran away, I don't know if you know what I'm talking about, but.
I do. And everybody's still on this Colin Kaepernick kneeling down stuff. I mean, he doesn't know no better. He has no other means of voicing his displeasure.
Right.
But we need to know. We need to keep the commandments of God.
Right.
That's where you come in, you blacks, you men that know you Israel and read this Bible and study. That's where you come in. Because you can take what happens in the news and bring it into the Bible, into today, to make our people see, man, this Bible talking about us. This Bible talking about us. And that's the job. The Most High is allowing this stuff to happen. Why? Because we forgot about him. He wants us to seek our face. But in order to seek his face, our people is looking around for, where am I going to go? What is the answer? I'm tired of seeing my people shot. What do? You come in with the Nehemiah 8:8. You read the scriptures. You give the sense. You cast down those imaginations in their mind about white Jesus, Christianity, being an American, the American way, the American nightmare. It ain't a dream to us.
Right.
You cast that down and replace it with the commandments of God. That's your job. But in order to do all that, you must have to get your house in order. Give me that.
Before you get there, I want to say something about what you said about Kaepernick. That's his name?
Kaepernick.
Apologize. Tabernacle was on fire. But anyway, Shannon Sharp, that's his name?
Yes, sir.
He was saying some powerful things. He's been saying strong things lately, right?
Right.
But then when people ask him, well, what's the answer? Guess what?
He ain't got it.
Nobody have the answers. That's where you men come in at. You men of God. You blacks, Hispanics, and Americans who are the true children of Israel. This is your job. This is where you come in at. Alright? You have to stand up. Hold on before you get that scripture. Give me Psalms 94 and 16. Because the Most High asks a question. You know what I'm saying?
Bring it up.
Which one of y'all gonna stand up to the question? Psalms 94:16. Read that.
Psalms chapter 94, verse 16.
Come on.
Who will rise up for me against the evildoers?
God said, who will rise up for me against the evildoers? The evildoers who break his commandments. Mm-hmm. All right, read on.
Or who will stand up for me against the workers of iniquity?
Same thing. He just reiterated it. Said it different. Same thing. Who gonna rise up for me against the workers of iniquity? The ones who push sin. If, the workers of it.
And if you know it or not, the ones that repented and said, I want to give my life over to the Most High and keep his commandments, statutes. You answered this call. Even if you want to sit on the couch and be a what do you call it, a Facebook Israelite,
right?
You ain't doing your job. You got employed, but you sitting at home.
Right, against other Israelites.
Right. You ain't doing your job, man.
And go wake up your people. That's and true. Tell them to keep God's commandments and the faith of Christ.
That's what
get off your butt.
That's what kills me. Will you? Who gonna rise up for me against the infidels? If you say I want to keep God's commandments and the faith of Christ, you've answered that call.
Right.
You might not be doing your job, but you answered. You filled out the application and you was hired. You just ain't started work yet. And you'll be judged for that too.
If I get fired,
right?
No man, listen. You're gonna be judged for that too.
Right.
No man know the hour. They got a parable about that. When Christ ain't playing with us.
The talents.
Christ ain't playing with us. Is he playing?
No. Let him come back. You ain't putting no works. No works in for this truth.
They got a parable Goodbye. About that with the officer going over. Do you understand that? If you ain't doing this work, you worrying about the other man. The Bible, that's how you know, that's how I know some of these brothers ain't reading. The Bible says after, what, two or three admonishment, then reject,
right.
You be on Facebook all day fussing with the people. If the brother won't keep the goofy alone thing, all right, bro.
When the order came out over a year ago to leave them alone, you're not going to pull a Shazam scripture. So to say, to have the light cut off. Oh, praises to the Most High. I get it now. Let me join IUIC. Brothers be really arguing with people online thinking that that's going to happen. That's not going to happen. Stop it, y'all. If they want to sit behind the computer with the keyboard all day and type out a whole chapter, right. Let them do it.
Right. They be doing it by themselves.
Not knowing that our people don't read. Why would you even... Come on. We know our people don't read like that, but you want to type out a whole chapter to try to get the brother.
Bruh, you don't never... I know you know me for a long time, y'all. Did you ever, ever see me all on Facebook?
Nope.
Did you ever, Solomon?
No.
Did you ever?
No, sir.
Never. You never see me all you, because you know what? I listen to the people who set up before me. Deacon Abiel,
the bishops,
the deacons, say a long time ago, it's not worth it to argue on Facebook. That's not the work.
That's not works at all.
First of all, how do you know that's the person? How do you know they ain't an Edomite? How do you know that could be any other nation just messing with you, laughing at you? The Bible says go out the street, cry out loud. Go out on the highways and byways. Right. The highways and byways ain't at your computer in your drawers.
Right.
Right. You being catfished. You being catfished on Facebook. Giving scriptures.
Yeah.
It's an Edomite back there. Ain't washed his butt in 20 days.
Oh man.
He got a picture of he found it on Google, and you arguing it back and forth with him. He like, look at this dumb nigga right here. Look at him. Look at him. He going back and forth with me.
I got him now.
His name isn't Jesus Christ. It's Yahweh Bib, Yahweh Shai. Let them brothers do that. Y'all, IUIC is not permitted to argue.
The Bible tell you not to do it. It's not, Bruh, it's not even IUIC thing. It's the Bible thing. Tell me when I'm lying. The Bible tell you not to do it. It's not how you, I mean,
right.
I don't understand why, and I'm talking to us, the brothers at IUIC. I be seeing, I be shaking my head. I'm like, man, these brothers do not listen. That's that vain glory.
Right.
They want everybody to know, look how many scriptures I know.
Pulling.
I know, I mean, look how many scriptures I know. Committing adultery.
They pull the scripture, but don't explain it. They just post it. They just post it straight out the app and don't explain it. Oh, I cut you out. I cut you. You cut. You didn't even explain the scripture. You can't, because guess what? You type it. How you gonna give the sense of you typing? Things get Mr. Screw when you type it stuff. Everybody knows that. That's why when it says you read in the Bible, you give the sense. But watch this. This is something we must do also.
Wait, hold on. Hold on one second. Go back to Nehemiah 8, because you said something is not. And read, go to verse 1. Because you said something heavy.
Huh?
8:1.
Yeah. But then just 8:1. I want to see, because you said it. But I want to show you the scriptures. Let's see if it was in a house on a computer. Let's read the Bible. Come on.
Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 1. And all the people gathered themselves together as one man into the street.
Into the house.
Into the street.
It was in the street. Read.
As one man into the street that was before the water gate.
Uh-huh.
And they spake unto Ezra the scribe to bring the book of the law of Moses, which the Lord had commanded to Israel.
Commanded to who?
Israel.
I just want to bring it out. Read.
And Ezra, the priest, brought the law before the congregation, both of men and women.
Both of what?
Both of men and women.
Some of these camps are my younger women supposed to be there. That, read. I didn't want to get into that.
And all that could hear with understanding upon the first day of the seventh month.
I just wanted to show you that these brothers and sisters, our brothers went out and taught the street. Before Israel. That's our job. He said, cry out loud. How you gonna cry out loud on the computer? Put it in all caps?
Right. Exclamation mark after exclamation mark.
Why he yelling at me? I never understood that. People be like, I'm like, bro, that's in writing. How you doing? I know people be saying that, but you can laugh at me all day. That's funny to me. He's yelling at me. Bro, it's in writing. Like, I didn't get you. I didn't yell.
You know that voice in your head. You know that voice in your head when you read stuff. You try to, like, if it's somebody you know that's writing, you try to put they voice in your head. And as soon as you go all caps, it goes from, you know what, you get on my nerves. It's just a mental thing, man. People really be taking it to heart, man. Just unfriending them on Facebook.
Listen,
they take it to heart, man. This is where we moving to, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's sad.
I'm glad we're bringing this out because we need to hear this.
You got to understand some people. Even though men and women, what you say on Facebook is being monitored. Not just by us. By people that's in the world that's still on your Facebook. You still bickering, you still gossiping on your Facebook, you still telling all of your business on Facebook, and the people that don't have bot or bit Israel on your page, still with their nigga coon name, is watching like,
Yeah.
She's still a nigga with a head wrap.
Right. And
he's still a nigga with a Bible.
Right. Cause you forgot you an example to the people. You an example. Your mother, your father, your sister, your aunties, they all watching. They might not know. You, look, I don't say a lot of things. I be seeing, I'm like, these people are retarded.
If they see IBI's Facebook page, you know what they going to see? Knowledge and current events of what's going on with our people.
Right.
That's what they going to see.
Right.
They going to see, man, I had a bad day at work. Esau getting on my nerve. I can't wait to put him in chains. Isaiah 14. Somebody look at that post in the world like, what the hell is wrong with this person? You think they're going to go back and read that scripture you posted? No. No. Mm-hmm. Because our people have a bad habit of not reading. You know, posting scriptures is cool. I do it. That's a good thing. Somebody scrolling down, they read a scripture, all praises. They read something pertaining to the Bible. One day they might ask, watch this. I have a brother that's from Duncan. He's 9-0 Crip ganged up, tattered on his face. You know, I'm posting what I post. I didn't know it was going to affect him. He inboxed me one day. He was like, hey, man, you know, shoot, man, I want to learn. I said, you want to learn what? I just want to see, was he trolling me? You know what I'm saying? Are you playing? Like, he was like, no, man, I really want to know, man, just because, you know, what your Facebook, you know what I'm saying, what you post on your Facebook, it makes sense. So what I did was I recorded a private video for that brother just to watch. You understand what I'm saying? I'm not gonna put him on blast and be like, oh, this brother is the brother. You know what I'm saying? I sowed the seed, that's all I could do. He asked questions, I answer it. Lord willing, he repent. But because of how I conducted myself on social media and in person, this brother felt comfortable for me asking me to teach him something that he didn't know according to the Bible. But if you posted, oh man, T.I., you posted a T.I., like a rapper, you know, Lil Wayne was arrested, or Lil Wayne said this, or wait, you know, you got Young Jeezy on your damn wait, post.
You know what, too? You know what? And this, bro, this makes me furious. And brothers have done this in this school, will post a post or something and put nothing else on it. Like, you with that. Like, they wouldn't put no scriptures. They just post it. Yeah, post this woman twerking. Bro, right. Why are you posting that? Break why? They'll be posting all kind of crap and don't say nothing on it.
I say for my person, you watch the words I say. It's Galatians 1.
Give me Ezekiel chapter 2. You got a scripture you want
to
bring
yeah.
up?
Yeah. 1 Thessalonians 5:22, because it goes into exactly what we're talking about.
Go ahead.
Get that. 1 Thessalonians 5:22. Abstain from all appearance of evil. That goes with your everyday life. You at 2:00 in the morning. You talking to a sister. You proving a sister, but you at our house until 2:00 in the morning. No chaperone. You may not have done nothing, but what that look like? You see what I'm saying? What did that look like? You might be going into a bar, but if the bar has loud music and people dancing on a table, should you be there? You on Facebook, you posted twerking videos, or you posted a half-naked sister. Look at this disgusting mess. My sisters are destroyed. And you posted that. Why would you post that?
Her, they don't even say that, bro.
Her breast and her booty out. You use Insta share, or you might write something like a scripture on it. The scripture is tainted by the picture itself,
bro.
She wears something see through. You can see everything, and you talk about Proverbs 7. You know, but no, shut up. Put just the post the scripture. Don't post the picture.
Put spirits on the
you
table,
brother. Right, you put spirits on people. You don't know what they dealing with. And you scroll down the timeline, they stop right there on your post, like, wow. They don't see the scripture. I'm telling you right now.
I was guilty of that thing, bro.
Watch this. They had a brother I seen yesterday post a scripture, post a video of people in the church, so called Holy Ghost dancing or whatever, right? He didn't, it's an invite. He didn't put no scriptures on it, he just posted it. So, guess what? The people who don't know nothing about Israel, the people who don't understand what's going on, they gonna think you with this. You post that. I understand you like you posted. You said, "Hey man, look at this." I understand that, but you an example. That's why he pulled that scripture.
Read it again, because I don't think people understand that. 1 Thessalonians 5:22. Abstain from all appearance of evil. Is that all on that?
Yes, yeah, sir.
Okay.
That's all appearance of evil.
That's cut and dry.
Brothers want to stand on that borderline.
Right.
Why? Brother told me, I'm like, brother, your child head is bald. Well, it wasn't with a razor. He got a little hair. I'm like, bro, it looked bald as hell. It looked bald. You just want to stand on that line. You just want to play with God, huh? You want, here the line is, and I want to stand on it. You want to tote that line? Oh, my dog on a haircut? Come on, man. Israel.
Or brother riding up the camp. bumping the most vulgar music you can. Let me think of a song. You bumping Biggie Smalls' Warning. Like I don't know how other vulgar you can get other than Biggie Smalls' Warning. You pull up the camp bumping that. It's already a crowd of people at the campsite. You hearing F this, B that. We gonna whip up some drugs. You bumping your Jeezy Thug Motivation 101. Yeah, that's all you hear coming out the truck. You bumping that coming out the truck talking about cut the white, break it down into grams. And then you get out of the car, shalom, Most High Christ bless. People that watched you pull up was like,
that nigga.
The hell is wrong with this nigga tripping.
Right.
Now you talking about shalom Israel, Most High Christ bless. We trying to tell you to repent. Wasn't you just bumping young Jeezy? Trap or die? But you
confusing as hell.
Right.
That's a confusion.
That's some state of evil. Or you go to Walmart bumping that right hard. You bumping it loud. You get out and try to hand somebody a flyer, they just watched you pull up look bumping that.
They got brothers. Look, I'm about to dive in that deep right now. They got brothers who go to camp, right? Screaming and teaching. Right? Then they in the club. Strip club. Whatever club. You know, listen.
You in the club with friends.
Y'all can go in there if y'all want. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying, you know, I'm not even going to Hooters.
Break it out.
I'm not going to Hooters.
I'm not going to Twin Peaks.
Right.
I'm not going to Hooters.
Coyote Ugly.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not going there. I don't care.
If I go to any establishment and the women are half dressed, I'm walking out immediately.
That's how y'all. What's that?
Immediately.
Immediately.
That's, you know, I mean, hey. Brothers like to play with it. They like to play with it. They know they're dealing with certain issues, and you won't play with that thing?
No discernment. That's what it comes down to. People that don't abstain from evil, like you in the truth, and you still sagging your damn pants. I'm sorry, language, but that is annoying to me. Shalom, Ak. You know what I'm saying? And I see you sagging. You blatantly sagging because you have on a belt.
Penguin.
And you got on fringes.
They had a brother.
Come on, man. Come on,
fringes,
man.
On a Superman shirt. Brothers with fringes on. I'm not doing stuff, bro. Certain things I'm not doing. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Bishop McClown, my brother. I'm just serious, bro. You got a big old smiley face, Edomite. I just can't do it.
I thought it was the S. You talking about really Superman on the shirt?
No, he was smiling. Superman was smiling there and his fringes on. He burned it. We got it on video. He burned it. After brothers in the room. I'm just saying, bro. We already in this. I mean, come on, man.
That's like having you remember those John Gotti shirts? You know, those hood shirts? That's like having a John Gotti shirt fringed. You got a gangster shirt. You got dudes holding Tommy guns and with a fringes and a border blue on it.
Now I can see you. All right. Now I can see this. If you want to wash your cars in the rags, I'm putting fringes on every day, right? And you washing your car, you don't want, you know, I can see you washing your car and that type of stuff. Washing your car, cutting your grass, doing it in those type of shirts, right? But not coming to this doggone Tabernacles.
Yeah, that's crazy to me.
I just want
to,
man, this is off topic, but can we this is funny.
See, this is what it boils down to.
Get that scripture.
Yeah,
get
that scripture. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 23.
You digress a little bit. Go ahead.
All things are lawful for me, but all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but all things edify not.
Like cussing. Cuss words are not a sin. But guess what? And I'm going around, you know, I'm not going to do that.
No.
Just, why?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Read it again.
1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 23. All things are lawful for me, but all things are not expedient.
All this is not good to do. Just because it's lawful don't mean it's good to do. He just pulled a scripture, abstain from all appearance of evil. Read on.
But all things are not expedient. All things are lawful for me, but all things edify not.
Oh, it don't edify. I'm sitting on the corner cussing out people.
Right. You use every other word as the B word, the F word, you know, the N word, you know. You talking to people like you at a cookout. And you supposed to be teaching God's word. That don't edify nobody. That's gonna turn the elderly of us off. If they 30 it up, they're going to be like, oh my God, he has a Bible, he got something like that.
Y'all have no, our people got to start having understanding. Right. Pray for that thing. I do. Pray for it. I pray for it every day.
When I came into this truth, I had a cussing problem. I grew up with 3 generations of cussing addicts.
Right.
Every other word was a cuss word.
Professional cussers.
Palu, Officer Palu, caught me on, like, cut me on a couple times. He's like, man, you ain't on even all that cussing, bro. Chill with the cussing. And I don't mind food in my mouth, bro. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because until somebody say something, I don't know. I'm just talking like I usually talk.
Right. It's normal to you.
Yeah, it's normal. You know, that's, so if somebody, I wish somebody would say, I tell them to, yo, chill out on the cussing. It ain't a sin. I'm telling you, I'm going in on you. I'm going in on you.
It's like the brother said, charity, you know, you thinking about your brother is to have some charity. You understand? You know, well, since you know it ain't a sin, you gonna just do it.
Right.
You know it's gonna offend people, but you don't care.
Right.
Well, your old ass should be like, You know? But you just old. This is new age now. I heard that from an intellect before.
Or somebody say that the 2/3 in the slums in the ghettos. I heard that from a camp too. Oh, no, we don't go to the hood in the ghetto. Because that's the 2/3.
Where Christ came from?
He came from Nazareth, the hood.
The ghetto.
Right.
The scripture said, can any good thing come out of them?
Right.
That's what the scripture say. He from where? Can any good thing come from there? He from the ghetto. Chirac.
That's what I was about to say. He from Chicago. What?
He from the ghetto. That's where Christ was from. I mean, I know y'all. Some of y'all get mad, but hey, that's the truth.
It is what it is.
He came here, but he won't like homeless. Boy, Kim's killing me with that too. He was homeless. He was a bum.
Right.
Yeah, right. Christ had a job. Christ had a house. Come on, man. Y'all ain't reading these scriptures. Give me Proverbs 15:28. Because people say stupid stuff like that. That lets me know this Bible ain't being open. And there ain't no understanding coming out of it if it ain't open. I'm going to be honest.
You know what they're doing?
Nobody fixing their eyes to look at the scripture.
They listening to men.
Then that means they ain't studying.
Listening to men.
If a man got a tip, that's why people strap a bomb on themselves right now, talking about Allah Akbar. They listen to a man.
Well, then what's that?
Allah Akbar. Boom.
It's over with.
Come on, read that. Proverbs 15:28.
Proverbs chapter 15, verse 28. The heart of the righteous studieth to answer.
The heart of the righteous study Why do we study? To answer our people's questions.
That's right.
You gonna be at camp and get confounded? Why? Because you don't study. Somebody come up to you and ask you a question like, Jews and Gentiles. I thought that the Gentiles were the other nations. You don't study, you're going to be like, and then resort to cussing them out. When they really had a genuine question.
Well, Cornelius is an Edomite.
Right, and if you don't study, you can't break that down.
I have seen brothers, not this camp, and some other camps, cannot break Cornelius down. All you gotta do is keep reading. That's all you gotta do.
Easy.
I mean, like, all you gotta do is keep reading. He talking about, yeah, you right. I'm like, this is the...
Or resort to cussing them out. This is our form. You can't tell us. S-H-I-T. You Edomite. You must be Edomite because you ask a question like that. The person talking to me on the street.
But and I'm gonna tell you this.
Crazy.
A lot of times y'all don't realize... This is what I've been telling the brothers. Look, you arguing with a, are you going back and forth with a somebody who I want to say is golf or whatever? They got other people listening. Speak to them people. Speak through him. You got a scripture?
You want me to finish it?
Yeah. Read it out. Yeah, finish that out.
Start it over.
Yeah, start it over. Proverbs. Proverbs chapter 15, verse 28. The heart of the righteous studied to answer. This is Proverbs from King Solomon. Proverbs are wise sayings that are true. It says, the righteous heart, meaning the righteous mind, studieth to answer. So, if you call yourself righteous and you don't study, how do you know you're righteous or not? Because righteous is keeping the commandments. Right. One of the commandments is to study. If you don't study, how are you righteous? You're not keeping all God's commandments because he said study to show thyself approved. That's a commandment.
Get that real quick.
What, 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15?
Yeah.
Get that.
Finish that up.
Yeah, finish that up. Read.
But the mouth of the wicked poured out evil things.
The mouth of the wicked poured out evil things. If you don't keep the commandments, right.
Nothing.
If you don't keep the commandments, something...
Wicked things, but meaning you can keep...
Second, you're right, Second Timothy.
Meaning you can keep the kufi on, you can marry 100 wives.
Look at the Pharisees and the scribes. They had the appearance of being righteous, but out their mouth came evil things. Why? Because they weren't keeping the commandments.
Right.
They called Christ Beelzebub and a wine devil.
Bruh.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
talking about... dirty hands gonna sink you to hell.
Right. You ain't gonna wash your hands before you eat?
Right. You're going to hell.
Christ.
That's sin.
Christ cut this off. Read that.
That's no way in the law.
Guess what? If the Pharisees and scribes would have studied and applied the scriptures, they would have knew who they were talking to. They would have knew that was Christ. But since they had not kept the commandments and not studied, they had no understanding of who was in front of them.
Now watch this. Y'all listen to this close. Read that.
2 Timothy chapter 3, chapter 2, verse 15.
This is what you're saying. Read.
Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed.
A workman? What's a workman? A man that got a job. He know what his job is. Read it over again.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needed not to be ashamed.
Shouldn't be ashamed of this work, y'all. Come on.
Rightly dividing the word of truth.
Because a nigga could go in his Bible and try to pull out anything. But if you study and you have the precepts, you can back anybody that don't know the scriptural context into a corner. That's the job. Because we got cast out of imagination. Christianity told everybody that Jesus Christ was a white man. And he had blue eyes and blonde hair. And he died on the cross
without everybody. Without a Bible. Because that's not in the Bible.
Right.
But read that again. I want to show you something.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 15. Study to show thyself approved unto God.
Stop. It says study to show yourself approved unto God. You just said earlier, if you don't read... How you know you're righteous? Right?
Right.
Read it again.
Study to show thyself approved unto God. a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of
truth. Read it again. I just noticed something. Read that again.
Study to show thyself approved unto God.
Study to show yourself approved unto God, right? How you study to show yourself approved unto God? Because I know we use the scripture to say, well, when you get asked a question, and you have to answer for the people. That's true. That's how you use that scripture. But I just thought of something. When you study to show yourself approved unto God, like this, when it's time to apply what you have been studying, and you pass the test.
Right.
You understand? Like the Bible say, you can get angry, but sin not.
Right.
The brother make you angry, you ain't hit him upside his head. You apply the scripture. A sister invite you in to go for dinner or whatever, and you know her intentions. You say no. Okay, I'm pretty sure you'll find you didn't know. Doing this, sitting down with you, I'm gonna apply with this, what I read about the scripture.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? That's how you do it as well. Because you've been studying. You know what not to do. You know I'm not gonna sit with a man wife by herself. This you and her in the house. Y'all sitting together, another man wife. Anything can happen.
Anything could happen.
So guess what?
Right.
I ain't gonna do it. I'ma leave.
Abstain from all appearances of evil.
You see that? Because guess what? I read that. That's how you show yourself study under God as well. Because when it's time to apply, you're gonna apply it.
Right.
I just want to bring that out. Hold on. This too. Get Ezekiel, chapter 2. Cause I said we have a job to do, right? In Ezekiel chapter 2, start at verse 1.
Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 1.
Come on.
And he said unto me, son of man, stand up on thy feet, and I will speak unto thee.
See, stand up on your feet like a man. Most high ain't no child. I don't know what they think this Bible is. This Bible don't make no punks.
Right.
Make men. He said, stand up on your feet. Read.
Verse 2. And the Spirit entered into me when he spake unto me.
These laws, this Bible, entered into him. Right? Because Christ said, what is John 6:63. The words I speak, they are light, they are spirit. Mm-hmm. Read.
And Spirit entered into me when he spake unto me, and set me upon my feet, that I heard him that spake unto me.
Come on.
And he said unto me, son of man, I send thee to the children of Israel.
This is you getting into the Bible. This is you Ezekiel, you reading the Bible, the Most High is speaking to you. This is what he's telling you. Stand up on your feet. Manfully, get up and go to the children of Israel. This is what he's telling all of us. Read.
And he said unto me, son of man, I send thee to the children of Israel, to a rebellious nation
Nation. Ain't our people rebellious? You got to know how to deal with our people. But that's the only way you're going to know how is you get into the scriptures. Read.
To a rebellious nation that hath rebelled against me.
Come on.
They and their fathers have transgressed against me.
Come on.
Even unto this very day.
That's how I know we're Israelites. We are rebellious people who will not hear God. Soon as you tell them you're an Israelite, they're all happy. But then when you tell them you gotta keep them law, they're looking at you like you the devil.
Right.
What? That stuff is done away. When you sound like a runaway slave, then.
The white man said I can do whatever I want.
Can't nobody keep all them laws.
We's free from them laws. You sound like a runaway slave.
We ain't gotta do that. God done away with those laws. What? Right.
What?
So it's okay that Terrence Crutcher got shot by the white man. That's not a sin then. Mm-hmm. It was okay for him to get shot. It was okay for Timmy Rice to get shot.
You know what makes me angry? And this is my people. It's okay for Jeremiah to go into captivity. Right? And he was righteous, wasn't he?
Yep.
We have all our folks. Christ even went into captivity. He was righteous, wasn't he?
Yep.
But the so-called white man didn't go into captivity. He got an inheritance with us. Bro, people so rebellious and
jacked up. They destroyed, bro.
I don't know.
The so-called white man did a number on us, man, but it was due to us not keeping God's commandments. And that's the job. That's the job to make them realize that look, the reason why you go through all the hell that you go through is due to you not keeping these commandments that your pastor, Pork Chop, told you that you didn't have to keep. That's a stronghold, man.
Keep reading. No, I'm finished what you're saying, bro.
No, that's up.
Okay. Keep reading.
And, Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 3. And he said unto me, Son of man, I send thee unto the children of Israel.
Go to 4.
Verse 4. For they are an impudent children and stiff hearted.
Stupid. Most of us call it stupid. Anytime somebody can tell you that Christ is white, the Bible tell you he's a black man, but they don't tell you with no scripture, you're stupid.
Yeah.
Nobody has seen, this is what they say, nobody's seen Christ. Well, who they hung on the cross then?
Right.
Who they hung on the cross if they ain't seen him?
Right.
How he died for your sins if they ain't seen him?
Right. Bruh, they had the pictures of all of our dead brothers that got shot by the police, and in the right corner, it was Caesar Bozier praying on a rock with a crown of thorns on his head.
What the hell?
Right. The reason why they died like that is because y'all believe that.
Read for again?
Come on, man. It's 2016. You got Google, and you can't Google Jesus Christ?
Right.
They can tell you anything without scripture.
As soon as you Google Jesus Christ, as soon as you do, the very first thing that pops up, when you know they got the suggestion line, Jesus Christ, Caesar Bozier. It's the number one option that pulls up when you Google Jesus Christ.
Right.
It just go to images. It shows you Caesar Bozier, and then it shows you Jesus Christ, the white image of Jesus Christ.
Right.
Our people are just that dumb.
Did the Bible? Wait, hold on. Are you saying that, or the Bible saying that?
Bible is saying that.
Read that again.
Ezekiel chapter 2, verse 4. They are impudent children.
Stupid. Stupid.
And hard-headed.
And it says stiff hearted, meaning they hard, they ain't gonna listen. The Bible said do it. You like, no, I can't see it, no. You read.
I do send thee unto them, and thou shalt say unto them, thus saith the Lord God.
Wait, hold on. Did it say, thus say Tyrone? Thus say your own words? Thus say your mama words? It said, thus say the Lord God. You have to, brothers. You have to speak what God's words is. You got to keep it as it is written. Romans 3 and 3. Read.
Verse 5. And they, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear.
That's how your demeanor must be. You can't be like no kitty cat. It says whether they will hear. Oh, when they forbear. If they don't want to hear it, or they want to hear it, I'm going to tell them anyway.
Right.
Look, I'm going to be honest. When I first started teaching, I was like, what scripture can I use to get everybody out here that hears this to repent? It's impossible. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. You treading on, you sugarcoat scripture, it's not going to cause your people to repent. When that spirit hits you and that scripture come out, you break it down plainly. If it hurts somebody's feelings, oh well, Isaiah 58 and 1, spare not. You can't save everybody. Two-thirds has got to die. I'm sorry. Period. You can't sugarcoat nothing. That goes for your family too. Now I'm not saying go through your house with your family just swagging scriptures to try to hurt their feelings. But if they ask a question, you bring it out the word, and your mama wearing pants and she don't want to wear pants. I mean, she wants to keep wearing pants. Don't be scared to read Deuteronomy 22 and 5. She got to know. Oh, why don't you wear pants? Because Deuteronomy 22 and 5 tells me that I don't have to wear pants, mom. I'm a woman. You ain't supposed to wear pants. You ain't supposed to be scared to tell her that. That's all I got to say.
Finish that.
For they are a rebellious house, yet shall they know that that there has been a prophet among them.
You don't know. You will know. Drop down to Ezekiel 3 and start at verse 1, because like we said, you have a job to do. And you just can't go out there screaming anything you want to scream. You got to scream what thus says the Lord.
Right.
So we're going to start at 1. Read that.
Ezekiel chapter 3 verse 1. Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest.
He said, eat that thou findest. What is he talking about? Read.
Eat this roll.
This Bible. Eat it. Hold that. Watch this. Give me Matthew chapter 4 verse 4.
I think that's Luke 4 for you. Thank you, Luke 4. Oh.
No, it's Matthew.
Okay.
Matthew chapter 4 verse 4. But he answered and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone.
Man shall not live by bread alone. This is your food too. Remember when the disciples said, Christ said, I ate already? He was like, what did he eat?
Right.
What you talking about? We ain't getting no food from him. He was in the scripture. He was studying. He was in his word. Go back.
Ezekiel chapter 3 verse 1. Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest. Eat this roll and go.
Meaning study. Study. Read.
Eat this roll and go speak unto the house of Israel.
Once you study and understood it, and I give you this power, then you go speak to Israel. You don't just go get up and just go yapping and stuff.
Get
like
you Facebook.
Computer Israelites.
Right.
Read.
Verse 2. So I opened my mouth and he caused me to eat that roll.
He gave him to understand it. Come on.
And he said unto me, son of man, cause thy belly to eat and fill thy bowels with this roll. That
get the understanding, read.
And fill thy bowels with this roll that I give thee. Then did I eat, and it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness.
Mm. This is good. Once you start understanding this word, and you start getting to this word, I don't care who you are. This thing is good.
Right.
This thing is good. Brothers be breaking down my door. Let's get the scriptures. Let's get in the scriptures. Come on.
Verse 4. And he said unto me, son of man, go, get thee unto the house of Israel.
So with all that understanding, all that reading, you just going to keep that to yourself? You're not going to tell your brothers and sisters? That's hatred.
Right. It's pure hatred.
You're not going to get out here in these streets and tell these people what requires them to make it to the kingdom? You think you're going to make it? Not like that.
That parable.
Not like that. Matter of fact, we're going to get that parable. Find that parable for me. The talent.
The talents or one of the pounds.
Oh, yeah, read on.
And he said unto me.
Right. Or confounded.
And even if you do be put to death, you still ain't getting in trouble because the Most High controls all that. He the one who's doing it. Read on.
Verse 5. For thou art not sent to a people of a strange speech and of a hard language, but to the house of Israel. Not too many people of a strange speech and of a hard language, whose words thou canst not understand. Surely, had I sent thee to them, they would have hearkened unto thee.
They would have listened to you. All right, these other nations, this is before Jake will.
Right.
But the Most High said, no, I'm dealing with you. All right, now drop down to 17. Yeah, we're gonna have to speed it up. I was gonna read the whole thing, but you got it?
Yeah.
All right, we're gonna read this and then we're gonna get that. Brothers, we have a job to do. We have a job to do, all right?
Read.
Ezekiel 17?
No, Ezekiel 3:17.
Ezekiel chapter 3 verse 17. Son of man, I have made thee a watchman unto the house of Israel.
What a watchman is. He looked out for approaching danger. He's a watchman. Read.
Therefore, hear the word at my mouth. and give them warning from me.
Hear the word, meaning get into the scriptures, listen to the word, hear the word, and give them warning. Give who warning? Israel. He's been saying it the whole while. Read.
Verse 18. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning.
So, read it again.
Verse 18. When I say unto the wicked, thou shalt surely die, and thou givest him not warning, nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way.
The Most High said, you will die if you be if you do such and such like whoremongering, interracial marriage, eating unclean foods,
being transgender or homosexual.
The Most High say you going to die. These are the things you have to teach. Me?
Nor speakest to warn the wicked from his wicked way to save his life. The same wicked man shall die in his iniquity.
You supposed to go out there and teach your people. This is what he's saying. Go out there and teach your people. I'm tired. I'm tired of this captivity. I'm tired of seeing my brother shot in the streets like a dog. I didn't know resisting arrest is a murder sentence.
I didn't know breaking down in the middle of the road was a death sentence either.
Right.
I didn't know waiting for your son to get out of school was a death sentence.
I'm tired of it, you know. And it's all because of our sins.
Right.
It's all because of our sins. So you have to stop arguing with these brothers who can't get right. And go to the people who want to accept the truth. Because the Bible says after the second, third announcement, then reject, leave them alone. Let it go. You talk to those who don't want to hear, because the Bible says whether they want to hear from there, that's right, that's it. But once you let it go, that's a wrap. Leave it alone. Move on. Read.
But his blood will I require at thine hand.
They're gonna cry out blood at our hand. You think you sitting down reading the Bible, you gonna sit at home all day, think you gonna get the kingdom? And you too scared? Oh, I don't need no camp. I can do this by myself. Okay, you're going to die by yourself.
Right.
You're going to die right in that room, in front of that computer.
That's how I know they ain't reading, because the High Holy Days are holy convocations. Convocations mean gathering. How do you gather by yourself?
Right.
How is that possible?
Like this.
Hugging yourself.
Yeah, remember that. You remember that in school, y'all?
Yep. That was what kills me.
Right.
About these lonelyites.
Show that old you is again, bro.
Golly,
about man. These lonelyites, man.
Hey, bro.
Yeah, I remember. Bro. That.
Listen, that's okay. Bro, y'all sick in the head.
Man,
right,
big time. Can I get a scripture before we get that
no,
parable?
Get it, man.
Well, give me Titus 2, man. Because sisters got a job too.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to start at verse 1, though, because the men got a guide, the household.
Yeah.
Because it makes no sense you out here teaching the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High God, and your house is completely out of order. The scriptures say, how can a man rule the church of God if he can't even rule his own household? You get no points for that. He could be one of the greatest breakdown artists on the street. People praise you for being a great teacher. You precepting it out, but your wife is the head of the household. You get no kingdom. You get no kingdom for that. Nobody, the Most High gonna be like, oh, he was a great teacher. You know what? I'm gonna let this one pass. Okay, keep thinking that.
I want you brothers to stop thinking that because you can speak well. Or you can remember scriptures, that's going to get you into the kingdom. Of application, that's it. Application, when you hear the scriptures and an incident occurred, something come up in your life, you apply the scriptures.
Right.
Period.
That's it.
Come on.
Titus chapter 2, verse 1.
Come on.
But speak thou the things which become sound doctrine.
Sound doctrine. Let's get the doctrine. Give me Proverbs 4, 2. Let's get what the sound doctrine is according to the scripture.
Proverbs chapter 4, verse 2. For I give you good doctrine.
Come on.
Forsake ye not my law.
The law is the good doctrine. Flip that. The law is the good doctrine. The sound doctrine. Come on.
But speak thou the things which become sound doctrine, that the aged man be sober, grave,
temperate. Sober, meaning you can't be no alcoholic, you can't be high on weed, you can't be in this doctrine, in that doctrine, in this doctrine, in that doctrine. You're torn to and fro. You got to be sober, man. You got to think level. Grave, serious, temperate, not quick to anger. Come on.
Temperate. Sound in faith.
Sound in faith. You ain't that brother that when something bad happened, you give all the, oh man, there ain't no God, man. Oh. I can't do this. I can't make it. Help me, please.
I thought you was my God.
I'm trying to do everything, man. I'm trying to keep all the commandments, man. It doesn't happen, man. Because I ain't hearing me, man.
I want a wife. I ain't got a wife. He got a wife. I don't got a wife.
Come on, man.
How come he got one? I don't got
them yellow make me sad, brothers. Come on.
Sound in faith, in charity.
And in charity. You care about your brethren. You ain't that lonelyite. You ain't stingy. You ain't selfish. You understand what I'm saying? Come on.
In patience.
You ain't quick to go off on somebody. Your children drop some water on the ground. They 3 years old. They just now learn how to hold their bottle themselves. They drop it on the floor. You spaz out. Your wife do something because she the weaker vessel that isn't something you approve, and you go you on her helmet.
Why is these bitches screaming on the wall?
You wicked. Come on, man.
It just had an earthquake this morning. What the hell wrong with you, bro?
Read verse 3, man.
Verse 3. The aged woman, likewise, if they be in behavior, has become in holiness.
In aged women, likewise. So all of the characteristics in verse 2, the woman has to have. Come on.
Not false accusers.
Not false accusers. Oh, she thinks she all that because she want to wear a blue head covering and I got a gray one. Women are simple like that. They don't need to be, but women are simple like that. She thinks she all that. She thinks she this. She thinks she that. False accuser. Oh, do you know so-and-so did this and didn't do none of that? Gossip, backbite, all of that. Come on.
Not giving too much wine.
She ain't no drunk. She ain't at a high holy day, stumbling all over the place in other men's faces.
Throwing up, looking stupid.
Read off.
Teachers of good things.
Teachers of good things. The good things is the commandments.
Right.
That's the good thing. She's teaching that to the children. She's teaching that to the younger sisters coming up. Come on.
That they may teach the young women to be sober.
Come on.
To love their husbands.
Women have to be taught how to love their husbands. That's not a natural occurring emotion. Right. They don't know that. When they say, I do, they don't know what they saying. I do. Oh, worldly, I know. But when they say, I take this, I want him to be his rib, I want to be his helpmate, they don't understand what that means. 99% of them don't. That's why these older women that's been in the truth have to teach them.
Right.
You have to submit. You know, women go to for counsel. He want me to do this. He want me to do that. I'm only one person. Sister, obey your husband. That's what they should be hearing. Now, oh, he tripping. I don't know why he asking you to do that. Well within the commandments, y'all. I'm not talking about have her get on her knees and bark like a dog. That's foolishness. But I'm saying within the commandments. Cook my dinner with my dinner ready at 8 o'clock when I get off.
Do it.
Do it.
Want the house clean. Want the house clean. Do it. That's your job.
I want my children in bed at this certain hour. I don't want my children watching this. I don't want my children doing this. They got to learn this. That's a trait that they have to learn. By the aid systems that's been in the truth. That's their job.
You have to be taught. You have to be taught.
Because they were going off of their mama's example.
You forgot we born into sin?
Right.
We born into sin. How come you can't tell, you don't have to teach a kid to take something? Like a toy. Kid to take a toy? right? And put it in his pocket. Nobody told him to do that. I'm talking about you walking out the store, and you, I'm like, where did that toilet from? And they're like, I ain't paying for that. You don't have to tell a kid that. They automatically know. You have to tell them, no, that's not right. We got to bring that back.
A kid will
lie. That's wrong. You have to teach them that.
Right, a kid will lie in a heartbeat.
Right or wrong?
Right.
A kid will lie in a heartbeat. Did you waste that? No. Kids will do that. They don't learn that. That's a lot.
You got to teach them.
They got to teach them.
You got to teach them how to be. You got to teach these young girls how to be ladylike. They just don't automatically know.
Because you got to understand, they had a worldly example. If they go off the example of what their mother left for his marriage, and they go, that's the first example they have. When they come into this truth and they take a man take her as a wife, her first example is her mother and father that she right. had. Even though it might be the wrong example, that's the only example she know. Right. That's why you older sisters, you in the truth, have to teach them. Read that part again.
And wait, hold on. And not just when you teaching them, you have to be patient. When you and your teacher, because we coming out of 20 years, 30 years, 40, they might have somebody 50 years coming out, coming wake up tomorrow. They've been 50 years of demon, lying and stealing, doing what they want to do. You have to be patient with that person. I'm talking about our elder sisters who've been in truth, you know, who lose it. The Bible says you have to be patient with them, show pity.
Read that again.
Titus chapter 2, verse 4. That they may teach the young women to be sober, to love their husbands, to love their children.
Yeah, guess what? The blacks, Hispanics, and Native American women have to be taught how to love their children. Because in the world before the commandments, they were teaching, they was feeding their children pork, shrimp, crab, catfish.
Making their women, making their children booty dances.
Right. Also letting their daughters wear pants, date. Boyfriend, girlfriend, letting their children, their boys do the same, condoning sex. They got to be taught how to love their children because they don't know it. They don't know how. Come on.
Verse 5, to be discreet, chaste.
Discreet, meaning they ain't all loud, all in the place to be. No, come on, man. Chaste, meaning they quick to open their legs to every man under the sun. Come on.
Keepers at home.
Keepers at home. They ain't looking to go out to the club every function. They making sure the house is straight.
That's what they're keeping at home, yes.
They make sure their house is straight. It's clean. It's in order.
Take care of the kids.
They in order. Come on.
Good. Obedient to their own husbands.
Obedient to their own husbands.
Wait, hold on, I want
to
bring this out. He right. He is right. A brother said, a lot of mothers think because they bought their children Jordans or outfits, that's a good mother.
Right.
Yeah. That's a good mother.
What happens is these parents nowadays want to be their children's friends.
Right.
And they think that that's good parenting.
Yeah.
They think, oh, my child can come and tell me anything.
He respects me.
The hell? I wish my child feel that comfortable to tell me anything. I'm ringing next. For real, this is in the world. Real talk. Parent even admit it. Yeah, I'm my child's friend. They come and tell me anything. So your child can tell you that they smoking weed and having sex. Yeah, I want them to tell me rather than hide it. If they hide it, they know that you don't condone it. That means that they know it's wrong. If they come and tell you, they don't think it's nothing wrong with it. You gonna sit here and have
and
a conversation.
That, no, 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 I'm gonna take you something.
The hell wrong with y'all?
I'm gonna tell you something real deep about this. Because I grew up in with this type of mindset, not me, but people around me who had parents like that. And you know what them children say? And they know it. My father and mother don't care about me. He ain't like a guy told me that his mother don't care like your mother do. But my mom wouldn't have that. I told you, my mom would play. She wouldn't have that. Like, she didn't care like this brother, you know what I'm talking about? He could be out hours of the night, 4 or 5, my man coming looking for him. That brother was sad about that. He's like, how was my mama come yelling at me for, you know, he wanted it. I don't know if y'all ever seen that before. I seen it many a times where the parents don't care where their kids at.
I will be the bad guy. I will be the villain in my house before my children think that they can do whatever they want to do and tell me about it.
Right.
The scripture said, why trimmest thy way for love?
That's what they're doing.
I want my child to love me and respect me, so I'm going to buy whatever they want. They can come tell me anything. No, the hell they can't. Not in my house. They better hide it, conceal it as much as they can. At the end of the day, it's going to come to the light, and Abi is going to get in that butt. You think I'm playing? My daddy didn't play, man. And I told his brother, I'm going to need help raising my child. Because my example of my father was... He wasn't there emotionally at all. He was there just to work and whoop ass. That's all he was there for.
Right.
Work and whoop. That's all my dad did. Was work and whoop. That's it. It wasn't no spending time with us. It wasn't no throwing the ball in the yard. It was, this is why my dad's name was Floyd, but my mama never called him Floyd. She called him Ed. His name isn't Ed. There's no Ed in his name. That's what my mama called him, because his name is Edward, last name Edwards. So she called him Ed. Ed, your children acting up, whooping. Then he'll sit down.
Damn.
Yeah. The most talking that he's ever done with us is while he's whooping us. For us, didn't I tell you not to do this, that, and the third? Done. No more talking. Now, that's the thought I have in my head with my children. Now, I need some guidance from the sons of God over here, the commandment keepers, to show me exactly how to conduct myself with my children. Right. And I'm man enough to say that.
Right. And me too.
I'll praise
it. And some people, in this truth, would be like, they going to keep the same thought how they was raised and raise their children the same way and try to incorporate commandments into it. No. You can't do what your parents did and then add a scripture and think that that's good parenting. You can't do it. As soon as my son touched them skills, and I'm going to beat his, and then I'm going to read the scripture to him. He's a child. He's supposed to like Skittles.
Right.
Listen, I was scared of that thing too, man. I need help with my kids. Because I didn't have that structure, that family structure that I can see. But I, like I said before, I have godly men around me that I watch. You know, I call Deacon Abi all the time. You know, I called certain men in this troop and ask them, what should I do from here? You know, I have this situation. I don't know what to do. You know, the Bible said do nothing without counsel.
Right.
You know,
and you understand that children is the next generation of this truth. If the Most High don't send Christ back in our lifetime, but in our children's lifetime, they got to be built up.
Right.
They have to. So we got, they will be carrying on the legacy. They're our avengers, like the scriptures say. They're our avengers for the enemy. If we teach them the same garbage that we was taught before the truth and mix it with scriptures, we going to have niggas with Bibles after we gone. And then rather than Israelites, they could be Israel from birth. But if we teach them nigger qualities, they gonna be niggas with scriptures. So I'm telling you, if y'all don't know how to raise your children and you wanna raise your children like your father raised you and your mother raised you, you better get counsel, bro. We better go to a break. DJ, Air McKeezy. We gotta cool off. We gotta cool off for a second, cause we just got on that. We just got on children, cause that's big, man. That's big in Israel. Children.
That's why we got a lot of work to do. We got a job to do. We got work to do. Stop playing games. Push each other. Encourage each other.
Let me say this with his children. You came into the truth, you got teenagers. And they still in your household. They don't have an option not to come to the Sabbath. They don't have an option to play sports on the Sabbath. It's not an option. You shouldn't even give them a, oh, we came in the troop after you started the season, so after this season, you can stop. The hell with that. They stopping immediately. The hell is this? Go ahead, play the music.
From my brothers, they be dying in bodies. From my brothers, they be dying in bodies. We be keeping the commandments, raising up the standard. That's why we keep it rolling.
We gonna keep it moving. We gonna keep it moving.
Where that scripture at?
Hold on, let me finish that Titus 2. Okay. Let's go. Let's finish. I'm not gonna stop and rant like that again, but let's go.
Can we start back at 5?
4.
Titus chapter 2, verse 4. That they may teach the young women to be sober, to love their husbands, to love their children.
You know what that does? That creates more order in the household with these young single sisters now knowing what to do when they get a husband. Now they won't be stood up in front of the congregation on foolishness because the older women that came up in this truth guided in the right way. That's you sisters' role. That's your job. Come on.
To be discreet, verse 5. To be discreet, chaste, keepers at home, good, obedient to their own husbands.
And if you do that and you teach that to the younger children and the younger sisters, they could be 30 years old and they one day in the truth, they younger sisters. You can be 25, been in this truth for 5 years. You are elder in wisdom, Lord willing. You know, Lord willing, it's supposed to be that way. Teaching them how to conduct themselves to get in order. God has always been about order. Read.
That the word of God be not blasphemed.
That the word of God be not blasphemed. Because God said that the man is the head of the household, the woman second, the children third. If it's anything other than that, it's out of order. It's going against God's word. The woman is supposed to be obedient to the husband, submissive to the husband. If it's not that way, the word of God is not being followed. That was what it means by the word of God being blasphemed. You're not doing according to thus saith the Lord.
That's why he said in Deuteronomy chapter 76, you are a holy people, you are separate people, you different. You don't eat the same things they eat, you don't dress like they dress. So when God said, this is my children, he ain't supposed to see a bunch of niggas and spicks and all kind of crap. That's how the word means blaspheme.
Right.
Because you're not keeping, you as Israel, not keeping God's word. You're living some type of other way.
Right. Living like a heathen. Calling yourself Israel, still living like a heathen. Come on.
Is that verse, you want verse 6? You want about the young men?
Yeah. Because that's our job too. Come on.
Titus chapter 2 verse 6. Young men likewise exhort to be sober.
It said young men exhort to be sober, meaning they should be looking at us and seeing how we act. And they want to be that way. We got brothers in this congregation that look up to us. And that's how it should be. They should see every week a brother that's been in, an officer or a soldier or a brother that's been in for a long time stand up and get kicked out for some foolishness that he could have prevented. Come on.
Young men likewise exhort to be sober-minded in all things, showing thyself a pattern of good works.
Because if they see us do good works, that's going to make them do good works, because children learn by observation. Because my parents used to say, don't do what I do, but do what I tell you to do. Right. You think that worked?
No.
No, it never works. That was probably the dumbest thing one of my parents have ever told me. You ain't supposed to do what I do. You're supposed to do what I tell you to do.
I never understood that.
So when they smoking cigarettes and tell me not to smoke cigarettes, and I started to smoke cigarettes.
Don't smoke these cigarettes. These things will kill you. You hear me?
But you smoking it.
Right. And then I got a pack of Cools at 16, and it was on until I came into the truth. And Lord willing, look, all praise to the Most High got me away from that. But that's, children learn by observation. If they see us, shalom, Most High Christ Plus, we got 3-year-olds that hold their hand out for that. That's progress.
Right. I mean,
that's progress.
Come in a room like this.
All praise.
Come in a room like this. And listen, you know what? I love to see kids do that. You know why? Because a lot of times brothers be, I see the kids get what you call it, whooped or they get yelled at or whatever, but they come in the next Sabbath or the next time they come in, they still shalom, you know, they come and hurry up and shalom you, right? But a brother get into it, he gotta go sit in the car with the headphones on. He don't want nobody to tell him nothing.
That's why we gotta be like newborn babes.
Yeah.
Because kids get corrected and they come right back.
You see what I'm saying? We have to learn that. I know it's not easy because we've been living this way, sir, but we have to learn it. We have to.
These children, man, will be mighty in the spirit, man. Because they get that early example. We learned drugs, cards, spades, dominoes, how to mistreat women.
Pride of ego.
You know what I'm saying?
That's what it is.
Pride and ego, we learn all of that.
Is.
Our children are learning commandments, how to act. You know what I'm saying? It's a complete difference. Right. Order. Men and women roles. Is that it on that?
No, sir.
Read on.
Verse 7. In all things, show thyself a pattern of good works.
Because these children go to show patterns of good works because they see the example of good works. Come on.
And wait, doctrine.
Hold on. Don't run. It says a pattern. Like, you keep on doing it. You don't do 2-3 things and then fall out the truth and you got to come back and do 2-3 things. No, it says a pattern. You keep on doing these good truths. Read.
In doctrine, showing uncorruptedness, gravity, sincerity, sound speech that cannot be condemned.
Meaning these children, these young ones in this truth, they're going to be moved out of this truth. Because they're going to learn what characteristics, real characteristics again?
In doctrine, showing uncorruptedness.
They're going to be in doctrine, showing uncorruptness. Somebody going to just come and tell them anything, and they believe it. They can say, no, according to thus saith the Lord, this is this and this is that. Right. They're going to stay in that boat. Come on.
Gravity.
Seriousness. Come on.
Sincerity.
They're going to be sincere about this truth. Come on.
Sound speech.
They're going to be caught up in their speech when they...
Because they're speaking God's word.
Right. Come on.
That cannot be condemned.
You can't condemn God's word.
At all.
That's how you know what sound speech is talking about. Read.
That he that is of the contrary part may be ashamed, having no evil thing to say of you.
That's our children now that's in these school systems. Like, let's say they get to high school. Lord willing, they don't. Lord willing, I hope they don't get into high school in this corrupt system. But let's say they do. And everybody, oh, why you dress like that? Why you act like that? They tearing them up in the scriptures. And them that is corrupted can't say nothing bad about it. Well, they don't get in trouble. They hoes. They ain't players. They
ain't pregnant.
Right. They can't say nothing evil about them. But, man, they get good grades. They squares. That ain't something evil. Right. That ain't evil at all.
Evil to a nigga.
Right.
Right.
That's it on that?
Yes, sir.
All right. Go ahead. I'm done. Appreciate you.
Okay. Go to Sirach chapter, because you're bringing up kids now. You got to bring them up under the law. This fall right under, we got a job to do. We have a job to do because the Bible says somewhere it says, teaching your kid grieves the enemy.
Yep.
Don't it say that?
Yeah. It grieves the enemy.
It grieves the enemy. Read that.
What you want? You just
said so. Oh, shoot. Sirach chapter 7 and 23.
Sirach chapter 7, verse 23. Hast thou children?
So the Most High said, you have children? Read.
Instruct them.
Instruct them. Just like the author was saying. The author was saying, you just don't just beat them. You instruct them. You teach them. You talk to them. Read.
And bow down their neck from their youth.
And you bow down their neck from their youth. You started off while they're small. You don't want, I'm going to wait till he get old. No, you started when they're small. Like, no, don't touch that.
Right.
You corrected them when they're small. Talking about, what Esau talking about now? How they can make up their mind. They want to wear a dress. They want to be a girl or a boy. If my son is putting on his mama's shoes, I'm like, get out of that for girls. So you gonna let him go play in the river? He wanna go swimming, so you gonna let him go play in the Mississippi? Go ahead. That don't make no sense.
Right. They treat kids like adults now. They can make their own decisions.
Yeah, that's what I said there about the Mississippi.
Right.
All of them don't encourage it. I'm sorry, bro. I'm just saying, right. Bro. They talking about he can make his own decisions and he confused.
A child ain't stupid. A child observes every facet of life, everything that's around him. So when the mother feeds the child first and the father second, he understands that he's over his father. That's why children get fed last, because they need to know their place. Mm-hmm. My mama used to feed me and my brother first, and we treated our dad like he was a nigga.
Right.
Because we felt like, should we get fed first? You know what I'm saying? Our mama is going to take our side over his side in the first place. And she always did. And guess what? He divorced her. Because no man want to feel like that.
Do the children.
And little subtle stuff like that goes a long way in a child's psyche.
That one.
Goes in a psyche. We got to understand that. Stop playing with your children. I think it's going to say that next.
Right.
Read on.
Read on. Verse 10, and we're going to get it. Stop playing with your children. This is 30.
Okay, come on.
Verse 24.
Keep reading.
Verse 24. Sirach, chapter 7, verse 24.
No, 23 again.
Verse 23. Hast thou children? Instruct them and bow down their neck from
them. How you instruct them with these laws that you command? You instruct them. No, don't do this, son. That's not right, son. That's for girls, son. Read.
Hast thou daughters? Have a care of their body and show not thyself children.
You have a care for their body. You don't put them in pants and high booty shorts and high mini skirts. You have a care for their body. You cover them up. You know where they at all times. You're not just sending them off to that person's house, this person's house. You have a care for their body.
You know who's a good example of that? Deacon Aviel, man.
Ooh.
He has three daughters, man. He follows that scripture right there, man. So if I have a daughter, I know exactly who to pattern my parenting towards. Deacon Abiel, man.
Right. And I'm telling you this. You will sleep by his house, you ain't know to sleep by anybody else's house. I'm telling you. He ain't playing that. Because he obeying the scriptures. It don't have nothing to do with you. You getting offended. He ain't gonna do nothing to his daughters. Because what the other brother might do. He don't know who. He's just obeying the scripture. That's what we got to get out of our feelings. Israel got feelings too much. The man obeying the scriptures. Your feelings hurt. Well, so be it.
Telling you.
My daughter ain't come by your house either.
Right.
Read on.
Verse 25. Marry thy daughter, and so shall thou have performed a weighty matter.
It's a weighty matter, because we got a lot of knuckleheads out here.
Right.
That's not easy to do.
I'm marrying my daughter, if I have one, Lord willing. I'm marrying her. She ain't going to be able to pick anybody she want to pick. I'm sorry, we're going back to the old days, arranged marriages. It's real, okay? Because look at the mistakes that some of these women in the world made. Talking about, I love him. And then they go back crying to their parents. He cheated on me. He got three kids. I'm tired of
beep, beep, beep.
But watch divorce court. It'll be the saddest stuff you ever heard. And that's because they married each other. You understand what I'm saying? She picked the man.
We fail to realize that our forefathers, they knew their wives from young.
From almost young, jump street.
From young. Like our kids now, I want my daughter, if Lord's will, if that brother is still in true, whatever, I'm still in true, whatever, or Lord's will, that's who I want to marry. The kids that is raised up there, I've watched that boy. I seen him. I don't want no just no Negro knocking on my door. I don't know who it is. And I'm showing up the door like Will Smith, Mark Lawrence with that gun.
I've always wanted to do that
in
real life.
With my sister.
I wanted to do that in real life.
I've done it with my sister.
Look about 30.
If my sister watching, she'd be laughing. Yeah, shotgun smiling and play ball. Come see my sister, you won't.
But I'm telling you.
Hold on.
Read that again.
Read it again.
read it again.
After that, go to 30.
Yeah, read it again and read 30.
Sirach chapter 7, verse 25. Marry thy daughter, and so shall thou have performed a weighty matter.
It didn't say that the daughter marry herself. It's talking about the parents. Marry your daughter. You've performed a weighty matter. Come on.
But give her to a man of understanding.
Give her to a man of understanding. Not let her choose a man of understanding. You give her to a man of understanding. That's a job of a parent.
It's a weighty matter, too.
That's
like
a job.
There's a lot of knuckleheads out here. That's not an easy job to do. It says weighty matter.
I'm willing to do it.
Weighty means heavy.
I'm willing to do it.
Ain't easy.
My daughter ain't gonna make no mistake and bring no nigga in my house. Oh, he just repented. I just told him about the truth in school, and we love each other. The hell you will.
I don't know that boy.
You've been growing up in the truth your whole life, and he just got the truth a week ago. And you want to marry him? The hell you will. Read on.
You on verse 30 or you want me to keep going?
It's time?
No. Chapter 30. Chapter 30, start at verse 2.
This is the last script. Okay,
it's 12 or 3.
Okay.
Yeah.
30 and 2?
Yeah.
Sirach chapter 30, verse 2. He that chastened his son shall have joy in him.
You see that? Now, when you read in 7, it tells you instruct him. So don't just be beating on him. It's the way you have to do it. Read on.
And shall rejoice of him among his acquaintance.
You gonna rejoice among your acquaintance, among my friends? I'm like, you see my son?
That's my boy.
You're
gonna
be proud.
That's my boy.
You're gonna have joy in him because you stopped that crap when he was a kid. You taught him the right way when he was a kid. Read.
Verse 3. He that teaches his son grieveth the enemy.
He that teaches his son, the Proverbs, 22 and 6 says, Train up a child
in the way he should go.
You start from small, little. Read.
He that teaches his son grieveth the enemy, and before his friends he shall rejoice of him.
Come on.
Though his father die, yet he is as though he were not dead. For he hath left one behind him that is like himself.
Because he trained him up in the ways of the law, statutes, and commandments. His father sat down and taught him his ways, which are good ways. They should be good ways. So when that father died, that son is exactly like his father.
That's why you know that hatred that Esau got ain't gone.
Right.
Because they teach their kids.
Right. That's why Judas Maccabeus' father... Wasn't his maddening Mattathias, Maccabeus,
yeah.
Judas and them father? Before he left, he said, take care of your brethren, take care of your people. And they did what their father did. Their father taught them right. It's almost like Mattathias never died. They picked up where he left off. And that's how we're supposed to be with our sons.
Right.
They should see Abiyah ben Israel in my son. They should see Yahusab ben Israel in his son. Lemuel's son, LJ. It's just like Lemuel. Mm-hmm. So if Lord forbid Lemuel died tomorrow, LJ is going to be just like his father.
He's passing on that
same torch. Hairstyle
passing
and everything.
On that torch.
Right.
Same hairstyle and everything.
If he cut his hair, his son cut his hair.
Right.
Guaranteed. Then you're going to do it, brother. All right. This little bishop watching. Right, he's watching right now.
But yeah, is there any more on that before?
Yeah, I wanna get what you were saying. Shoot.
What are you looking for that? Also Deacon IBL's son Ari. He tries to do his shofar like his daddy do. He be trying to, you know, stand and walk like his daddy do. That's powerful, man, because the son know that his father is the example. And he wants to live that example like his father.
Verse 11.
It's beautiful, bro. I can't wait to have a son, Lord. Well, the Lord bless you with one.
Sirach, chapter 30, verse 11.
Told you have a son. I said it right here on Periscope. Boy. I told Jeremiah he was having a boy.
Sirach. Sirach, chapter 30, verse 11. Give him no liberty in his youth, and weep not at his follies.
That's both of them. The man child, and woman child. Don't give them liberty. Don't just give them what they want to do. That's what I see. Sometimes when I go back home, I'm like, man, look at these kids.
Too much freedom.
Just give him too much freedom. Read.
Verse 12. Bow down his neck while he is young. And
give him something to do. Go take out the trash. Mop the floors. Clean up your room. Give him chores.
Right.
So he'll be accustomed to doing things, not be a lazy bum.
Break it out.
Playing video games all day.
Bring it out.
You have to put that in that child. Read.
Bow down his neck while he is young, and beat him on his sides while he is a child.
Did it say punch him in the face?
And beat him on his sides while he is a child.
Beat him on his side, meaning his behind. His sides, that's his behind, his butt. You ain't suplexing your kids. This ain't WWF.
I watched the father videotape him and his son putting on gloves and him beating his son's face in with gloves on.
Oh, yeah, I see.
I seen one dude.
And he wondered why his son got taken by DHS. His son was bruised and bloody, crying. He's like, see, if you would have did what you're supposed to do at school, would you have to do it? No, son. He's bleeding. He's swollen up, bro. Kind of discipline is.
And you, I got to go to jail? Yeah, you got to go to jail, stupid.
And he posted on Facebook like, that's good parenting. Our people are crazy.
I got to go to jail now. Yeah, you retarded.
That people is crazy, man.
You see that dude who beat that child in the street, boxed him? I can't remember. I know it was like a fence. He was outside a fence, and he beat him like it was another, like, he was a man on another street. Like, he never knew the man. He beat his butt, because he smoked weed. All right, he smoked weed. That's bad, yes. But he beat this dude like this, he was like, caught him with his wife or something. That's how you beat this boy.
Terrible. That's what I'm saying.
We don't have no sense.
That's what I'm saying. You can't come in Israel with those same characteristics to treat your children. You can't
and
do
if
it.
We see it, we're correcting it.
Quickly.
We're correcting it. Because a lot of times, and that's with the women too. When I was in the world, I had a girl told me, because I wouldn't hit her, I didn't love her.
Yeah, that's psychotic.
She known love by abuse. Me grabbing her or stuff like that by the neck. You don't love me. I'm like, because she's seen her parents do that. She's seen her dad beat them up. And that's how she showed. That's why people be saying love. They don't know what love is. Because you can just say love willy-nilly.
You punch in the throat.
It's love. When we out in the streets, it takes love. But when you tell them what love is, they don't know.
Right.
People know love is getting beat up. All right, we almost finished. We need to finish that off.
Bow down his neck while he is young, and beat him on his sides while he is a child, lest he wax stubborn.
Lest he wax stubborn. He ain't gonna do what he ain't. He ain't listening to nothing you say, cause you waited too late.
Mm-hmm.
You wanna correct him when he's 15. He's 16. He's 6'2" now. He looking down at you like, I'm gonna do what? Man, I'm out of here. I'm going over here by Tyrone. Then we gonna go. He tell you what he gonna do. I'm gonna go shoot some dice, ma. Get out of here. Shoot some dice. Go, you know, handle my business. Get this girl. I'm gonna be back. Have my dinner done. He tell you. He didn't flip the script on you. He's stubborn as hell. He ain't listening to nothing you say. Read on.
Lest he wax stubborn and be disobedient unto thee.
That's it.
And the scriptures is true.
And be disobedient to you. He listens to nothing you say.
Nothing.
Nothing the teachers say. Nothing the police say. No, nobody can tell him nothing. You raised that boy. Oh, you didn't raise him.
You raised him to death. That's what you raised him.
But that's it. We ran over time. You know, we try to get a little time because we, you know, we came in a little bit late, so we try to go over a little bit for y'all. M-God. Something music, bro.
Let's get that music in. Hey, all praise to the Most High. I hope that was edifying. We gone. We out of here. We about to fade in. Who? Sabbath is tonight, y'all. Get everything y'all need. Right. Yeah, we gone though. Shalom. Most High Christ bless.
I'm Officer Yahusai.
Officer Abia.
Soldier Lemuel.
And we out.
Yeah. Shalom, y'all. Most High Christ bless. Shalom. Love you all. Israel.